Uti, mommy volume.
Jules, baby, Jules.
It's your boy. Yeah. Nice to meet you. You think said you are the revolver around your bamba. You think said you are the rotate around your bamba. You all the revolve around your fine face. Pull up. Right now I call you where you know they be. Right now I call you where you know they be. Take off, you get them 1,000 followers on Instagram. Right now I put me through the boys they like. Pull up.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Esther Onyina, and on behalf of the community, the GAM, and everybody, I would like to take this privilege or the opportunity to welcome you to this beautiful program. I hope you enjoy. I've watched the film. I don't need to tell you. You have to watch and then you judge for yourself. So take your seat, relax. There are more to eat. We dance and then we go home. Thank you and then enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you for those words. Eliana, if we could welcome her. Stand up. Yes. Eliana!
Thank you. Can we Akui just walked in.
How was this experience for you?
Well, thank you very much. As Mama Veronica said, we are already in this acting for a while now. Acting or playing the role wasn't the problem for me, but the main point is I'm addressed to have HIV. You understand? And I was just looking around me and I'm like, okay. But at the end of the day, I'm not anyway.
Hey, Mano.
I'm just an actress and it was very challenging, but I did my best by the grace of God.
I have to ask you the same question. How was this for you and why did you do this?
Thanks so much. Being a pastor, you won't think as Fidel already taught, like, she's going to have a problem.
Mm-hmm.
But with a pastor, everything about pastor is good.
Mm-hmm.
So,
so you're
always, you don't have any problem with community.
Your role was easy.
Yeah, even if people take it personal or not personal, because any at the end, you give good results and also bring an idea in a spiritual way for people to understand.
But then again, you also played a very important role. Could you tell us something about how important the role of the pastor is in Ghanaian society here in Amsterdam with regards to this issue, which is taboo?
Pastors are being the last stop, the end result. Like, people want to be healed instantly, because of late, fake pastors have been prophesying and taking money from people and then lying that, oh, I can heal HIV. And can you believe, people also believe, and they pay huge sums of money.
Yeah.
So if we have a good belief in our pastors and we take their instructions, in Africa, we always believe that sex is for married people. Then how come people enjoy by not getting married?
Can we get the real, where's the real pastor? Lord God bless you, sir. Could you please come here? Let me just watch. Sir, welcome. Seeing the video and hearing us discuss here, what do you have to say about this?
Thank you. This opportunity and the grace you give me, this microphone, is only by grace of God. My name is Pastor Gabriel. I'm from Amsterdam also. I like this movie I see today. I like to tell somebody here, the title is No Socks, No Shoes. Means a good sock. I like to tell somebody, good sock is Jesus. If you like to protect your life, it's only God can protect you. Nobody. Doctor is good, it's wisdom. God gives to doctor to give opportunity to help people. May good protector is only God.
Yeah.
If you love God, you can also walk in the principle. It's God of principle. You need to stop sin, to stop bad, to follow Jesus in the truth, to love only one wife, to have to your wife, to protect your wife, to protect yourself, to not have this sickness. It's only Jesus can protect you. Nobody can protect you. And if we have this sickness, also you go to God in the truth, God also can heal you, he can also protect you. Not forget, hell exists, paradise also exists.
So, do I understand that even though we need the protection of the Most High, that the protection with the sock is also an important one?
Yes, it's very important, and the people don't believe.
Now,
they believe and they won't.
Honestly, between us here on this stage, how important is Veronica's work through this movie for the community? Because there are some things people will only address between you and me and for the eyes of God, but they won't share with their brother or their sister. So how important is it that Veronica made this movie to show for everybody to see?
Hallelujah. I see this movie, my sister Veronica, you do this movie to protect us from people. If you see this movie, the gentleman, woman, he have good husband, he married already. May like to go again to do something mystic, he don't know. He give him now problem. The movie like to tell us you need to be in one way, not steal. If you steal, if you do sin, you do bad, consequence of sin is death. The consequence for this woman, this one, he come to ashway to death. to sickness. Because a good husband, he like to go again to steal. And the past husband, dead, he wait for him.
Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Because we need some other guests on stage. Give him a round of applause, please, please, please. And I would like to have Wim here as well. Where is Wim? Yeah. You can be seated. In English, there is a saying. My mother always said it. She said, the strong move quiet and the weak cause riots. Now, when you do what Astrid does, you have to be very strong. And you also have to be very quiet. Because you get to hear stories from people, mothers who have children who are infected. If you're not strong, if you're not quiet, you won't be able to deal with the things you have to deal with on a daily basis. So could we give her a round of applause for the work she does? Yeah. And having that said, Astrid, how important was it for you to be part of this project?
Well, thank you for inviting me here also. Well, I think it's very important, and it was great to be participant here and to help, because it's so important to give a lot of information about HIV and the possibility that it can be treated. And we have also the possibility nowadays to have one tablet a day. It's a combination tablet, so it makes it more easy to take for a lot of people. And if you take it well, you can grow old, so you don't have to get sick. That's very important. And we also know that a lot of people don't know yet their status because they didn't test yet. So,
how big is that problem? Because as I said the strong move quiet, but I didn't say that for no reason. You see the reality.
Yes.
And the reality is not a very happy one.
No.
Tell us a bit about that.
Well, we see people who have this virus already for a long time, and then they are already very sick.
And they don't talk about it, they don't get tested.
They don't talk about it, they don't test, and well, sometimes they are admitted in the hospital, and then they are tested, and then we know that it's HIV that's making them so sick.
And sometimes it's too late.
Yeah, sometimes it's too late.
Nuria, yes. How is that for you? Because you two are on the battlefield. You see the women come in. Can I ask something? It's a bit rude, no disrespect to the men. But how cooperative are the men? Because this man who was with Janet, he was hiding, he was denying. While he was there in the bed.
Yes.
Is this a reality?
Well, at my work at GGD from Amsterdam, I only see the people who come for the testing.
Yeah.
And it's very, very important what Veronica does now, that a lot of people, they have to come to test. And also, like the man in the film, no socks, no shoes.
Yeah.
He didn't knew he has HIV.
So
if you come for testing, should he have come?
Yeah.
He should have known he has HIV. He went to Astrid, to the AMC, and then Janet.
Yeah. Oh, this is not Janet, only. It is Janet.
Okay.
So, can you stand up?
So it's very important that the people know that they can be treated, be tested, and if you have the HIV, you can be treated. And it's a lot of time the people, they get to know that they don't have HIV, but sometimes they have an STI, and also that can be treated.
Treated.
Okay. So it's very important.
Can I ask you something, just as a man, yeah? Because Fidel is beautiful, eh? So just for example, let's just pretend like we're in a movie, yeah? And you or I would want to be with her. As a man, would you dare to say, Fidel, I have a wife or I have a girlfriend, but I want to be with you. Shall we first go to the KKD to make sure?
I think when it reaches there, it's a point of no return. So you're saying it's too hot. You're already too hot. You can't wait to play.
No. I'm just, we're trying to, is that how it is? Usually it's too late.
Yeah. Unless maybe you're having a bad thought. Maybe he's into people or men. Or if he's a man, he's into women. Then you think of that. Then do that before you move on. But like 10 years, you haven't heard anything. She's so fresh, even better than before.
Yeah.
Then how do you have to stretch yourself?
You have the memory of back then. Fidel, would you dare, just as if we're in a movie, obviously not in real life, if a man would approach you, you say, go to KKD.
No, just technically, this is a movie now, we were pretending. Would you say something like that, or would you get caught up like in the movie?
No, I would.
You wouldn't?
No, and if I would even ask him to protect himself, the only reason is I'll get pregnant.
Yeah.
So protect yourself.
Okay.
But not to say of disease.
Okay. So that still remains a
yes.
bit of a...
Yes.
So,
let's be honest, there's grown-ups here, but there's a lot of young people that I miss who this is actually about. I'm going to do my test in a few minutes and I'll show everybody. But shall I tell you, I was so scared. When they asked me, are you going to do the test? I was so scared because I had a girlfriend and we broke up. Then a few months later, I heard she was pregnant with another man. So I called my sister and my sister said, this is a problem. So now I have to do this on television, on this stage. So I was so scared, I went to the hospital earlier this week to make sure. Yeah, you don't want to be here and then, you know, you get bad news. But do you know what that shows? That even me here propagating, get tested, I make my mistakes. What is the way forward? Because you've been playing the role of the man who was not taking his responsibility. The tests are free, but how will we get these youngsters to get into their mind that they should go and get themselves tested?
Thank you. Well, I think you've thrown that question to a lot of people, and probably if you are actually expecting someone to tell you straightforward that let's go and have a test, man, I don't think it will, in other words, it will tend to ruin the whole thing. So therefore, I want to get closer to you. And there may be something ringing in my mind that what for? Probably if I go and then I get a result that I never expected, it's going to ruin the whole weekend. So also, this will not actually encourage me to go that way. So this is about attitude. You see, it comes down to attitude. Our attitude of maybe how do you call it? Galvanizing the courage, yeah, and then checking into a health facility and then make sure that, yeah, we know our status.
Yeah.
It is very difficult.
It's very difficult.
Yeah.
Viv, can I maybe ask you, in the light of what I was saying, shouldn't it become normal for all of us, black, white, yellow, green, to get tested every year?
Yes.
Once a year.
Yes.
And then still use a condom, but just for you to know, my status is okay. And if my status is not okay, I can communicate with my partner, just as I saw in the movie where Veronica played a role. What do you say?
Yeah, I would like that. I think when it comes to doing the HIV test, it should be as normal as, for example, doing your blood pressure test or something like that. Or, and that's exactly the problem, and that's what shows here also in this discussion, is that there are lots of taboos about sex. Like the pastor said, the norm is you have sex with your spouse, and your spouse is the first partner you have sex with, but everybody knows that most people have sex partners before they marry, and a lot of people even have sex partners apart from other sex partners than the ones they are married to, and we don't discuss that, and maybe we should discuss that, but maybe we don't have to discuss it as long as we're doing HIV and STI testing every once in a while.
Yeah.
So I agree with you.
So what should we be doing from now? Because from your experience, you've seen a lot. We still have a higher rate of HIV in this area.
Yes.
Within the black community, especially the African community. I always feel discriminated when I go to the Khekhede, they say, come to you at Africa. I'm like, yeah, I'm from Africa. What are you talking about? But then the fact is, me being from Africa means that there's a higher risk.
Yes.
What are your thoughts on this? What should we be doing?
Well, I think everybody in the room should question him or herself, do I need to get tested? Or maybe you shouldn't question yourself, but just do the test, because it has become very easy nowadays. And you can even test this evening,
this evening in
the other room, and if you think that is not for me this evening, you can also go on Monday and Tuesday to the Municipal Health Service for... There's a possibility to do free testing now, Monday and Tuesday, 9 to 12 in the morning, 2 to 5 in the afternoon.
Yeah.
And if you still need some more time to think about it, you can always go to the Municipal Health Service or go to your GP the next time you're there, your house doctor. For whatever reason, when you're there, ask your house doctor, can I also do an HIV test?
For example, some men have sex with men. There are women who have sex with women who have a husband. Mm-hmm. Let's not pretend that these things don't happen. If I go to the KKD, what will they do with the information I share with them?
Well, people like Nuria and GPs also in the Netherlands, they don't tell partners.
Everything is anonymous, so nobody has to be afraid that we give information to partners or to GPs.
So even if you think you have something, you can go and it will be confidential.
Yes, 100%.
Veronica, now I have one last question for you. For a long time, the men have been blamed. When these things go wrong, it is the men. But what you are showing here in this series is, the women, they have their own,
I feel so dirty. I don't know what to do.
Calm down.
I cheated.
Put yourself together.
I remember when we went to the radio to promote this. Because we are not calling it condom, so now it's soft. The whole community is soft. Shoe. And then one man said that some of the shoes don't even like to be worn with socks. So which means, yeah, it's not only the men who don't want to use the condom, but there are some women who are also saying that the condom is missile, like
Yeah.
So it's both, but I know the men are, yeah.
They are the ones who should.
They are the ones who are really rejecting.
No! You see this?
Exactly, because you know it's all about men condom. Maybe the professionals have to think about making the women condom more nicer and flexible to use.
See, Veronica's trying to help herself, not only an advocate, but she's also saying we need some enhanced technology to make the woman condom a better thing to deal with. Yeah. Pastor, amen. Okay.
Yeah, the question is like that, then we can take full control of ourselves. Because now you have to give it to the man to wear. If the man don't want it, it's like you are dependent on the man to be safe. But if the woman condom is more nicer and flexible and easier, I won't come to you. I just put it on and just say, come on, let's go.
You know.
There's a thin line between maybe getting honey and then getting on it, you know. So within that instance, it becomes difficult. But before that, let me correct an impression here. Initially, I think you invited a pastor to give or elaborate on this. We are talking about scientific breakthrough in medicine, yeah. So bringing in spirituality doesn't work. I don't think it works. When someone got in the movie, when she contracted HIV and she was actually confused about what to do, she consulted a pastor. That was after the friend wasn't able to give her any advice as from there. She confronted the pastor, and then the pastor said, okay, the pastor was also 10 that year. Go to the medical facility and make sure you get some treatment. And thank God today, I think HIV is no longer a death sentence. Thanks to, how do you call, antiretroviral drugs. So someone can live with that. Yeah, so the whole thing comes down to attitude of maybe checking into health facility, make sure you get tested. And what can save you is getting early detection. Because if you leave it to a lapse, and then it gets to a certain level, because within the movie, some part of the movie that signifies that, I think, the lady or the man, the husband, asked that, is it possible that I can ever have unprotected sex with my wife again? And then the doctor said, okay, there's likely a possibility, but I need to run a thorough check on her to see the level of her distance within the blood. And thereon, I can advise you whether you can have an unprotected sex or something like that. So this is the integral part of the whole movie, and then I think that message was clear.
Yeah.
So we shouldn't be talking about all mixing spirituality with medical, scientific, breakthrough.
But obviously, I remember my mother shipping in medicine from the medicine man in the village in Uganda, and my father, who had to stop my mother from taking that stuff, which had been in the post for God knows how long, because you could become sicker and eventually die as a result of those mixing up of spirituality. But I also want to say, I do not want to take away the element of that spiritual encounter. And I'm happy that people like the pastor are here today and say, hey, I believe and I bring the word of God, but we should also look at what science does. So thank you for being here. And thank you to all our panelists and members here this evening. Could you give them a round of applause?
Because I'm going to get tested now. Lining up alone, she's a tester and counselor at the RFR checkpoint. I would like to give the last word to Veronica and to Wim, and I would like to thank all of you here on stage. And whoever wants to get tested with me or wants to do it anonymously later on, have your go. But let's start with Wim.
Well, what I would like to say is that we enjoyed working with Gam TV very, very much. We learned a lot, and we hope to continue that in the near future.
I also want to take this opportunity to encourage everyone, because with improvement in treatment, you can still have a long and healthy life with HIV. So please, let's take this advantage. It's just at the corner. Get tested and don't be scared. We are trying to break this taboo. Okay. Thank you.
Raina, could you come? And could somebody take some pictures? Because I'm going to share this on Facebook, because I think everybody should see that this is something that we should be doing. If Raina can take a seat, if you want to move, it's okay. I'll be here. Yeah, I'll sit here. Yeah. So if... And I'm scared of needles, people, so this is not good for me. If I start crying, just forgive me. Oh my God. So. Okay. It's looking for antibodies. My fingers are shaking, sorry. So that's 12 weeks. Now, is it okay if I look the other way when you prick me with that? You're laughing. Okay. That was okay. So now she's pushing my finger. Oh my gosh. And it's about the two dots. Either you get two or one. What's that?
Yeah, I'm going to put your blood now so in a membrane, and then in a minute we are going to see one blue dot. One blue dot means the test is working properly. If we see two blue dots, that means it's reactive. it means there are HIV antibodies in your blood if you have two dots. Yeah, if it's just one, then it's fine.
Yeah. So that's the thing where you should, you know, but you know what's important? If you go and do the test anonymously, the person that takes the test has at least a minute before you actually know what's going on that they can see where your result is heading. So keep in mind that you should go to a place, either here or at one of the institutions, the KKD or the hospital, where you can do a test so that you have the right people who you can talk to when you get your result. Because going to the test is one thing, but being with the right people to get the right consultancy when you get your result is even more important, because you know, if your result is not good, then you're going to have, you need some counseling. So
exactly. And we have a testing center in the center of Amsterdam, Jode Breestraat, and you can just come in, it's free, it's anonymous, and you don't have to make an appointment. We are open 3 days a week at the moment, so just come and get tested.
So now I see something like one dot, and what you're going to do now? Oh God, you're laughing at me, because I'm still scared, hey, I see one dot.
Oh, mm-hmm. You people, you better get tested, because I did this, so you should do this as well. Thank you so much. Let me just take one and you can see the one dot. Okay.
I am relieved
from this project. Loretta, I love you. Loretta, I won't say mother, sister.
But first then I would like to invite Eliana to the stage. The woman
is for saying yes. I am mother for 3 children, 15 years, 10 years and 8 years. Why did I do that? Yeah, I can give you short my message. I was almost 26. I went in a hospital for my diabetes checkup. And in my family, we have diabetes from families. So I was already 4 years busy checking up on my diabetes. Then we moved with my husband in Angola. And then just I was in a new country, I have to continue my routine checkup. So doctor in Angola said, new patients in this hospital, they have to do HIV test. Yeah, I was not scared, because I already did for my first pregnancy, I already did HIV test to know that I can breastfeed, and I did it for 1 year and 3 months, my daughter breastfeeding. So I said, no problem. So I gave blood, and then after, I have to wait 1 week, and I was not curious at all, because I said, yeah, it's no problem. Then I go in that room. What I missed was like somebody was gonna tell me, you have this sickness, but don't worry. That's what we miss. Even here, I was looking in this no socks, no shoes. When they are telling you result, they didn't tell you, you are going to be okay. I missed that when I was 25. On my first day, I hear I am HIV positive. Doctor told me, you are HIV positive. I said, huh? And I asked, my next question was, am I going to have a children? She said, you are crazy. How can you think about having children? You're going to die. Go buy a coffin to wait for you. And she sent me home, no prescription. She sent me letter to go home to lie down and wait to die. But my husband came home. He said, you are already 4 years taking medication for your diabetes. And then this is gonna be a few tablets you're gonna add to your medication, and it's just gonna be okay. Instead of doctor telling me you're gonna be okay, my husband supported me that moment. I just owe him so much. I am so glad he did that moment. And then I said, what am I gonna do next? I continue. You saw me how I dance. That's how I have been the whole my life, dancing. I'm just party girl. So I continue to do what I like to do. But my big target was, I'm going to fight with that woman who said I'm going to die. I'm going to try not to die so that she can see I'm not going to die. I waited 3 years taking my medication. I said, hey, I'm not dead. So after that, I said, now I'm going to have a baby. 2006, I was pregnant. That was after 3 years. I get a baby, and the HIV test for my baby was negative. And I say, hallelujah, I am the winner. And then I came here in Netherlands. I came with the HIV, yeah? That was 2007. And then when I was going in the arms, yeah, I used to see Astrid, was my consultant actually. Give her applause. What are you? Thank you, Astrid. And oh yeah, you are here. And then I got a baby number, my son was born again here in Amsey. He was also HIV negative. Now he's he's 8 years, he's in our group 5. So I am just a woman who likes to do what she can. And HIV, one thing, you never take your knowledge, your talent, your beautiful, everything you can do, you can continue because medication helps very well, good. You cannot infect anyone. You are just there as any simple person. Because when I'm dancing here, I do like my foot like this. Did you see any HIV jumping here? Did you read it here? When I tell you I have HIV, you said, why are you looking so beautiful? Then I say, were you expecting me to go like a zombie? I'm not a zombie. I'm just great. So to say one thing, stigma, it's a very bad thing here in our community. But I said, I told myself, why would I be scared? It took me 10 years before I talk openly about my status. Because I realized how important it is to know. Because if I didn't find out, thanks to my diabetes, I found out on time and I take medication, now I look healthy. That's why it's very important. People, they will jump quickly to point the fingers, say, oh, you are a prostitute, oh, you are a homo, oh, you are a blah, 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 you are from Africa. But they don't think about, what about your status? I always ask them, do you really know your status? No. Did you ever do HIV test? No, I don't, not yet. How do you know you don't have it? Because you can never read it here, only when you are already sick. Please, you want to save yourself, your life, you want your better future, you don't want to end up taking everyday medication like me. Test, if you know, take medication, accept it, but if you are HIV negative, then keep it that way. But you have to find out. You cannot know like, no pastor is gonna pray, say, please, Jesus, let me figure out who is in my people in my church who has HIV, who don't have, and I can tell them, you don't have it yet, so please, I can tell them. No, pastor will never tell you. Pastor will never tell you, hey, you know, God told me you are sleeping with somebody there and that guy, he has HIV. He will never tell you that. You need to figure out yourself. In the end, it's about between you and your God. Pastor is between us. He's between people. He's a person like us. We all believe, I believe in Jesus because somebody once told me, yeah, HIV is a curse from God. I said, no, your God is not mine. Because the God that I believe did bless me with the children because I want to have a children. How can God curse me with the HIV and give me children without HIV? Can you see the wonder of medication? Because I took medication, my children were protected from HIV. Hallelujah.
My name is Timothy. And the question that I had, well, you actually dealt with it a little bit. I saw the film, and it's a good film, but the most glaring omission that I thought to myself is everything is done within the context of heterosexual contact. And we're in one of the biggest LGBT cities in Europe, so, you know what?
I asked Veronica this.
And what do you have to say about that?
And Veronica said that she has plans for another episode, another series. But, you know, you have to take things step by step. I don't know, Veronica, what was your... Because you have a very good question.
This, to create awareness, we have to start somewhere. So, it's coming.
It's coming.
I remember when my mother was sick, did not have medicine. For a long time... Excuse me. We did not tell anybody that she was sick. I was wondering how you deal with the fact that you are open about your status, but you're also raising children. And those children also have right to a life, and those children go out to play with other children. And I remember going out to play with other children and not being able to tell their parents what the status of my mother was. Do you have any advice for people who know they're HIV positive in how to deal with raising the children and communicating their status to other people who might not be as tolerant as you are yourself or your close surroundings?
For me, at my home, with my family, there is no taboo. We talk with everything, all the different things in what's happening in the life. Telling other children, it was not for me a big problem because I communicate with their parents. Normally, children are not really dangerous. The parents are the one who make them, the children, a little bit, yeah, with a little bit crazy ideas, with the, to put them ready to be a little bit scared. But once you communicate with the parents, they are okay with you, and they are okay with the right information. You have to be in very, I treat it very easy way to tell without making them scared, because I said, I came in this country with the HIV. That moment you saw me, first moment you saw me, I already have HIV. That means we already have, we already share coffee, we have did a lot of things together. So then they realize, they try to look at me, try to see if they can see something different, but they say, we don't see anything, so it's fine. Then they know it's okay. Then I tell them the medication, they tell them. Then always question is, your children have HIV? I say, no. And then they know my kids can play, no problem. So,
the gentleman, you're the last question. It's a very important, your name and the question. And
yeah, thank you. my name is Harrison. First of all, I'd like to say a very big thank you to all GAM members, and of course the directors who made sure this came to light. Quick one, you asked a question which was not really answered, and it was like, with all these things, why are still people not getting tested? That's my problem. Why is it so? Now, I myself have been, I went tested a couple of years ago, that was long. There was something I saw I did not like. The lady who, you know, the Infegesprek or something like that, hi, hello, how are you, what's your name, and those things, yeah, I'm Harrison. Well, before he started with the pricking and everything, when was the last time you had sex, have you had multiple sex partners? I said, yes. And she was like, okay, how many? And I'm like, nah, I don't know. Okay, did you use protection? I said, well, the first time, yes, but you know, after the first time, I don't think it's necessary. I know her now, so I wasn't using them. And she was like, okay, really? The facial expression alone scared me. I'm being frank, it scared me. And I'm like, okay. If I had not determined to find out, I could have just said, okay, you know what, let's forget it.
You're saying you were scared of her?
The reaction alone, without even the test coming out, whether to know if I'm...
So to them, what would your
question be? Yes, to them, it's just an advice. You should make it attractive for us to come there. Make it, you know, normal, lively. Yes, we do all stuff, but, you know, if it's not that lively, we don't come. But and also, when next time, I hope they sponsor more. The stigma is more important. That is what will make us come and test. When I want to come with a friend to test, and it's bad, what will that friend say on the spot? Now, our lady, beautiful lady here, was so lucky. The husband was, you know, brave enough, supported. But probably you don't advise our wives. Well, look, my wife know I have gonorrhea. STI. When I tested, I didn't have HIV, but I was. And they said, can you please bring your spouse? How am I going to tell my spouse I have gonorrhea?
That's a very good question.
Yeah. I'll have a problem.
Okay, that's the last question, but it's a very good one. Thank you. Can we give him an applause for his honesty?
Because I think this is, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. You know why? Because honest men like you are going to help us forward. Yeah, this is last year.
Thank you for your question. We ask all the questions about how many people you had sex with and if you use a condom, yes or no. It's important for us to do the right testing. And if you have a gonorrhea, you will get treated for that. And then it's important that your spouse also get treated, but because it's so contagious, that maybe she will have it also. And if you are treated and you have contact, sexual contact with your partner, you will get it back. Yes, we call it the ping pong effect. So it's important she knows about it also for her health. And sometimes if it's very difficult, we can also do it. So if you don't dare to do it, the people from the GGD like me can do it for you. Is that the answer?
I think the other question has to do with, if I may answer your second question, your first question. I think your first question also has to do with how many people from within our community want to get into this business and study and do the work. Because, you know, if I would go over there and I see somebody who looks like me, his facial or her facial expression might be slightly different. Or if she can greet me in my, you know, my mother tongue. So to go to them and say, yeah, the way one of your colleagues looked at me, I think that's a point you're making, but it addresses the point of how diverse is the GGD and how are the people that work at the GGD communicating with the people that come to the GGD. I think that's a very important question you're asking, but I would also say that it's important that the GGD becomes as diverse as this city actually is, eventually. Because, but I don't know if I'm saying something strange. Harrison, was that okay? Yeah, because I understand what you're saying. Somebody looks at you when you give them an honest answer, like, what have you been doing? And you feel bad, so then you don't want to engage. I think that's a very good question. And I think maybe that, as I said, you can reply to that. If I'm honest and I say I've had multiple sex partners or I had an orgy, and you look at me like, wow, what have you been doing? That's what he's saying.
I only can say it in Dutch. Wij kijken nergens van op. So,
maybe you had the wrong one.
Maybe. And we are also testing here in the area with the GGD.
But could the GGD be maybe slightly more diverse in the future, hopefully, if we have some more...
We have very diverse colleagues, and everybody's welcome. And so you told in the beginning the color, the size, the sexual... No, everybody is welcome. And wij kijken nergens van op. And we're also tasting in Zuidoost.
Okay, thank you very much, Pete.
Thank you. Yeah. Oh yeah. There's one more important thing Ashut has to say.
Yeah, it is also important, but I think Nuria knows that very well. The GGD is also busy with partner notification. So what you told us just now, that if yourself you don't dare to talk about it to your partner, well, the GGD can maybe help you to see how it is possible to do it anonymously.
Yes, and now we have, we call it in Dutch, partnerwaarschuwing.nl. And it's anonymous, you can do it through internet. So your partner doesn't know that the warning comes from you. So it's very easy.
Okay.
And you get...
advanced.
Yes.
They're advanced,
and
man.
It works very good.
Okay.
So when you are warned through internet, anonymous, and you come with us, you will get betrayed.
They're doing a very good job.
Thank you.
Helping the community a lot. But my question is, this HIV is killing our people in Africa back home. That's very dangerous for Africans. And since they're educating us, giving us awareness, what plan do we have future for Africans?
That one is difficult.
First of all, I think we need to get rid of bad leaders.
My dear sister and friend, Veronica, and your group, I appreciate you so much, what you're doing for the community. And one thing that I'm missing that first was that, if it is airborne disease, maybe sitting by me, if I have it, and then I'm going to give it to a sister or something. Can you fix it back next time? And thank you so much. First of all, you have to know my name. My name is Nana Sewa Bonsuajidebi. I'm also a queen mother from our local village in Ghana. And I'm living here as a community mother for the youth. And I do many things as a writer and also storytelling for the young ones. I appreciate so much. I was having a best friend in school and returning back home, and she was very much sick. And because I love her, I took her to the clinic. And there she was diagnosed and having this. I told her, let this stay in between me. She was shocked and surprised. I loved her more than she was like my own baby. I want to carry her even on my back, do everything. Her cup, we drink, which she look at me. She asked me, Ama, why do you want to share a cup with me? I'm dangerous to you. I have HIV. I smile and laugh to her and I say, this is not an airborne disease. So, yeah. And my question to ask is, going to the checkups, checking your blood test or going some tests and all this. Sometimes you check your blood pressures and everything. If with this check, if you have this kind of HIV disease, can you find it in that situation? Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Give everybody a round of applause. Thank you so much. Yeah. And enjoy the music and enjoy the food, which is that way. And hope to see you next time. And tell everybody that they know that they should be here. Thank you so much. Yeah.
live, the 360 video, you can actually see about South Africa, where everyone gets on the streets for AIDS awareness. So that's what I show with these goggles.
We zijn deze avond bij No Limit voor de première van No Socks, No Shoes. En ik ga een paar mensen een aantal vragen stellen over vanavond. Ten eerste hebben we de Bertus van SOA AIDS.
Goedenavond.
Goedenavond. Ja, kunt u ons een beetje iets vertellen van uw indruk van vanavond?
Ja, ik ben helemaal verweldigd van de sterren en de glamour en hoe mensen er fantastisch uitzien. Het is een fantastisch feest. Een hele mooie afsluiting van een vijfdelige televisieserie die hier op de lokale televisie is geweest. Die we samen met Scham TV hebben mogen ontwikkelen. Over de rol van HIV en AIDS en SOA's binnen de Afrikaanse gemeenschap. Wij vinden het heel belangrijk vanuit SOA AIDS Nederland om samen met de doelgroep vorm te geven aan de boodschap. En in GAM TV hebben we een geweldige partner gevonden. En als je die serie kijkt, het zijn geweldige acteurs en actrices. En ook de professionals van de GGD en van het AMC hebben echt heel goed en geacteerd, maar ook echt hun eigen werk laten zien. En dat is een hele mooie combinatie om het taboe te doorbreken en om seksualiteit en HIV bespreekbaar te maken. Onze boodschap is, praat over HIV, HIV en andere SOA's met elkaar. Doorbreek het taboe, maak het bespreekbaar. En dat je ook goed kunt leven met HIV. Als je de medicijnen neemt, op tijd neemt, kan je gewoon een goed, gezond, positief, lang leven hebben. Dat is onze boodschap.
Wat is de indruk vanavond?
Ik vind het een hele goede avond. En mooi dat er zoveel mensen gekomen zijn. En ja, ik denk dat het goed is dat het belangrijk is dat mensen weten dat ze getest worden op SOA's en HIV. En ja, dat is heel belangrijk, want hoe eerder je weet, hoe beter dat is, want dan kan je behandeld worden.
En heeft u verwachtingen voor deze avond?
Ja, dat vind ik een moeilijke vraag. En ja, ik denk dat het goed is dat iedereen er is en dat er zoveel organisaties die hiermee bezig zijn vertegenwoordigd zijn en dat het allemaal via No Socks, No Shoes zo mooi in beeld is gebracht en dat er zo veel aandacht wordt geschonken aan dit belangrijke onderwerp.
Ik ben Astrid van Hes, ik ben verpleegkundig consulent van het AMC.
Oké, okay. En u bent hier gekomen, u hebt een kleine voorproefje gehad van wat vanavond allemaal gekomen. Wat is uw indruk tot nu toe?
Nou, ik vind het heel fijn dat er zoveel mensen zijn gekomen. En ze zien er zo prachtig uit. Ik vind het heel mooi. De sterren te zien zo. Ja, heel fijn dat er zoveel mensen komen. Ja, heel belangrijk.
Oké, en wat voor boodschap wilt u vanavond uitdragen naar al die mensen die straks gekomen en die hier al zijn?
Nou, dat we toch wel wat meer informatie over HIV kunnen delen met elkaar. En ja, dat het goed behandelbaar is. Gelukkig, mensen kunnen er tegenwoordig oud mee worden. Als je je medicijnen maar goed inneemt. Ja, en we hopen dat er ook mensen wat meer zich durven te testen. Want dat is het beste. Ja, dan kan je behandeld worden. En ook je partner niet, dan hoef je je partner niet te infecteren. Dat is belangrijk.
Oké. Nog één vraag, ja. Je weet, onze Ghanese gemeenschap, wij praten niet heel graag over seks. Nee. Nou, eigenlijk helemaal niet. Nee. Dus heeft u misschien ideeën van hoe u vanavond die taboe een beetje gaat doorbreken?
Ja, dat is lastig. Het is toch belangrijk om voor ieder om dat toch te proberen binnen de familie of binnen het gezin. En misschien nu de No Socks, No Shoes, hè, die serie nu, dat maakt dat mensen erover kunnen praten. Hè? Ik begrijp dat er veel mensen zitten te kijken.
Ja, zeker.
Ja, dat het niet zo'n taboe blijft. Hè? Want dat is heel naar en dat zo'n taboe blijft. Dus fijn als mensen daar durven over te praten met elkaar. Ja, ja.
Ik denk wel dat het goed komt vanavond. Maar er gaan nog meer mensen komen, want de avond is nog vroeg.
Ja,
dus,
absoluut.
Ja. Okay. Heeft u nog een laatste iets of wil iemand groeten of zo?
Nou ja, iedereen die hierover praat, dat is fantastisch. Dat is heel fijn. Dus toch probeer je toch te laten testen. Dat is toch even beter om het te weten. Hè? Of je HIV heeft of niet. En dan kun je behandeld worden. Ja.
Oké, hele fijne avond. Goedenavond. Avond. Hoi.
Hi. Ik ben Rineke de Man. Ik heb samen met Veronica en andere collega's van Zo Heet Nederland dit project opgezet. Ja, dat is heel... Het is onwijs leuk om vanavond te zien hoe dat allemaal bij elkaar komt.
Dus toen jullie begonnen met dit project, wat hebben jullie allemaal in gedachten?
We hadden met Veronica gezeten en het leek ons heel erg leuk om samen te gaan werken. En inderdaad om met elkaar iets te maken wat echt vanuit de community komt. En niet zeg maar wat wij als Zo Heet Nederland bedacht hebben, maar wat echt van onderop komt, zodat het de mensen ook in hun community echt aanspreekt. Dus dat hebben we geprobeerd.
Oké, en je hebt het resultaat kunnen zien op televisie. En hoe is dat allemaal voor je?
Ik heb een paar dingen gezien, maar nog niet alles. Dus ik ben onwijs benieuwd hoe het er vanavond... alles erop staat. En volgens mij is de compilatie die we te zien krijgen. Dus ik ben heel erg benieuwd. Ja, die compilatie heb ik nog niet gezien.
En ik heb alle episodes gekeken tot de laatste.
Ja,
zat de laatste. Ik zat elke woensdag spannend achter de televisie.
Ja,
als ik ergens was, ik zei, oh nee, het is 9 uur. Ik wil echt gaan kijken en zo. Het was echt net als The Bold and Beautiful in het begin. Dus voor mij is het boodschap er echt duidelijk overgekomen. En ik vond het leuk, er zit humor in. Het is niet alleen maar zo zwaar, weet je, maar ook
andere... Dat was de bedoeling, andere... om het inderdaad, zeg maar, om met humor en met vrolijkheid en om op een positieve manier toch ook een boodschap over te kunnen brengen. En het met elkaar ergens over te kunnen hebben. En dus het is heel leuk om jouw reactie te horen. Want dat is wat we wilden natuurlijk. Dat mensen gewoon aan de buis gekluisterd zitten en het mooi vinden om te kijken.
Ja, zo was het ook. Dus uw boodschap is echt duidelijk overgekomen.
Wijs leuk, ja. Ik hoop gewoon dat het, wat ik heel tof vind, zeg maar, we staan hier gewoon in de Bijlmer, met iedereen is zo mooi aangekleed en het ziet er tof uit en lekkere Afrikaanse muziek. Dus volgens mij moeten we er gewoon een goed feestje van maken.
Het gaat zeker een geweldige feest worden. Nou, bedankt.
Ik ben Wim Zuilhoff en ik werk voor Zo Heet Nederland en ik ben betrokken bij de productie. Ik ben ontzettend trots op het product. En ik ben ontzettend blij met de mensen van GAM TV. En ik heb ontzettend veel plezier met hen eraan gewerkt. En was verbaasd over de professionaliteit en de betrokkenheid. En geweldig. Het is ook een mooie avond vanavond.
Zeker weten, zeker weten. Maar voordat we hier naartoe kwamen, had u misschien wat verwachtingen van... wat kan ik van deze avond verwachten?
Nou, nee, niet echt. Ik hoop dat er mensen zouden zijn. Nou, die zijn er. Dat is heel fijn. En mensen zien er echt prachtig uit. Dat is ook heel fijn. Het is heel feestelijk. En dat we met z'n allen een feestje zouden vieren. Nou, daar ziet het wel naar uit. En het is ook een bijzondere week. Het is de Amsterdamse HIV Testenweek. En de soap is een ongelooflijk spannend En daarin zit, is ook veel aandacht voor HIV en SOA testen. Dat hebben ze ongelooflijk goed gedaan. En ik hoop dat het mensen nadoet denken over HIV testen. En dat, want dat vind ik, dat iedereen eens een keer in zijn leven ook een HIV test doet. Dat is belangrijk. En daar hebben we ook deze testenweek voor.
In onze Ghanese gemeenschap, ik weet niet of u heeft meegekregen, maar we praten echt helemaal niet over seks en zeker niet over SOA's. Toen u thuis was, had u misschien een beetje bedacht van hoe u deze taboe een beetje gaat doorbreken vanavond?
Nou, als het goed is, hebben we straks een paneldiscussie, daar zit ik in. En dan wil ik daar het een en ander op zeggen. Ja, weet je wat, ik vind het echt briljant deze soap, want... Kijk, Ghanezen zijn niet zoveel anders dan witte Nederlanders, denk ik. Mensen hebben over het algemeen... Iedereen kan lacherig praten over seks. Maar zodra het over hen zelf gaat, houdt iedereen zijn mondje dicht. En als het gaat over HIV en SOA-risico's... zegt iedereen, oh, het zal zo'n vaart niet lopen. En daar zijn we allemaal een beetje, daar zijn we allemaal hetzelfde in. En wat we ons moeten realiseren tegenwoordig... dat het gewoon belangrijk is dat je laat testen. Omdat als je... Stel dat je HIV hebt, en dat hebben gelukkig niet iedereen, maar als je het wel hebt, is het goede nieuws als je nu medicatie gebruikt. Dat je na een aantal maanden ondetecteerbaar bent. Dat betekent dat het virus eigenlijk zo ver in je lichaam is teruggedrongen, dat je niet meer ziek wordt. En ook dat je het niet meer kan overdragen aan anderen. En het is dus om twee redenen ontzettend belangrijk dat je laat testen. Want laat je niet testen, dan gebeurt dat vaak pas op het moment dat je verschijnselen hebt die je wijzen op HIV. En dan ben je eigenlijk al vrij laat. Ja.
Nou, ik weet zeker dat het een geweldige avond gaat worden. En ik hoop dat heel veel op het programma staat. En dat we allemaal echt een geweldige avond gaan hebben. Ja. En dat niet alleen, dat het de boodschap echt heel duidelijk overkomt bij al die mensen.
Ja, dat hoop ik ook. Ik vind het nu al een geweldige avond. En ik vond het ontzettend fijn om met GAM TV gewerkt te hebben. En ik hoop dat in de toekomst vaker te kunnen doen.
Bedanken voor uw tijd.
Ik ben Nina Schat en ik werk voor de AIDS Healthcare Foundation. En wij hebben een checkpoint hier in Amsterdam waar je gratis en anoniem een HIV-sneltest kan laten doen. En wij zijn samen met SOA AIDS Nederland en GAM TV de organisator van deze avond. En wij bieden achterin helemaal vlak bij de kleedruimtes kan iedereen die hier ook vanavond is kan een HIV-sneltest laten doen. En het resultaat is binnen 1 minuut. Ja, het is dus een sneltest, je ziet het meteen. En we willen eigenlijk daarmee de drempel verlagen om je te laten testen. Het is heel makkelijk, het gaat heel snel. En we willen gewoon bevorderen, net als iedereen hier, dat meer mensen hun status kennen en ook sneller in behandeling gaan.
Oh, dat is echt fijn. Heb je ook misschien een plan hoe je dat allemaal voor me gaat krijgen vanavond? Want ik denk mensen denken ze komen naar een feestje. En ik denk er is ook echt angst bij mensen om te laten testen. Want je weet nooit wat eruit kan komen.
Dat is waar. Nou ja, dat is ook precies waar de soap dus over gaat. No socks, no shoes. Daar wordt er ook onder de aandacht gebracht, aan de orde gesteld in de soap. En aan het einde van de paneldiscussie zal de host van de avond, Andrew Mackinga, zal zich ook op het podium laten testen. Ook om te laten zien hoe makkelijk het is, maar ook om te delen met iedereen die er is van hey, het is beter om het te weten, sowieso altijd. Het is inderdaad heel erg moeilijk en eng, maar de behandelingsopties zijn zo goed. Dus het is altijd beter om het te weten.
Nou, ik hoop dat er echt mensen gaan zijn die dat vanavond gaan doen. En heb je misschien een beetje verwachting van deze avond?
Ik denk dat het een waanzinnig leuke avond gaat worden. En dat het inderdaad, zoals we willen, een avond zonder taboes gaat worden. Want dat is het allerbelangrijkste om die te doorbreken, denk ik.
En ik denk wel dat het goed komt.
Ik denk het ook, ja. En als jij... wil ik langskomen voor een HIV-sneltest, dan ben je heel erg welkom.
Oké. Okay. Ja, ik zou er wel even over nadenken. Nee, ik doe het. Oké. Okay. Nou, ik wil je bedanken voor je tijd.
I love it to be here, to make photos. Take away, to move.
fronta esa no kwa baka e wine no wine me dente so jagela e so ke pressure wa do kwen no resha wo kwen ye ke mama ya bi bateya su ne chancha ne meshe nom shema kan so ma kan se na me mudi ya no ashe shema budu ya me buda diem na me mudi ya mu odene shema fije man don zi ba kami ni mi mu ode budo ya Nana nyami na bechere Mi ne ube guro kape Atre yas jaman say Ya no ya Nana nyami na bechere Me ye wu campaign Atre yas jaman say Yina budo ya Nana nyami na bechere Why do? Chemasu masian sana gas oil. Ne mehu ningi na wana da waye. Nse fu bito me da she bites. Chwa bu mu slow me mehu defense. Nse ni mi yempa usensi ya ye. Happy na yensi wo so kode. Chwa 1 2 3 aja odim. Eya sente. Fa won sa be wo many. Under me wo ya she. Fa won tu ma be bo me dia no. Eto za bo kode ye. Fa won sa be wo many. Under wo ti na mi be. Fa won tu ma. And no socks, no shoes. Ya wo original bobo e wa ha. Na me pese me busa se e dia ben. Bien no man front ya oba ha ne ba obetimi aka mi bi akira ye ne o eyu e na odun se
yo mi da se pa ohun e fesu because e ne very special day because Gam TV for no omo boy e papa o kromo ha especially according to research you know obi ni papa no was stress but because of Gam TV no almost certain akor be 50% This one more boy, you are from and yeah easy. But with Gam TV, the way almost the almost movies in our trail, the CNU is stretching our quarter. But they have more of my basu so that you have more time to give us more ideas. It is because of that room, the bars have about support home. Say, oh, my way. No more especially say, how pay a man, but acquire Friday. It is Nipaba Babodia, but because Omo Koya Juma, I can a weekend there will be no problem. But because Omo Yina Yajumanti, make sure Omo Yina Beba, they are support you, Gam TV, no more Komo Nim.
Yeah, that's it. Now, movie in the Sono, 5 episodes in about TV in the Sono. What do you mean, baby?
True, maybe we can cry, but. I feel I'm having my way in now, but who starting the year movie now? Who say my information pa? Because they say this way was I said information time. If you only information, what will crack right here? If you moving, even my information will break. If you be on want to any time about or the okay.
Yeah, that was super brave. Yeah, nim say and ebeye wonderful. I have a ma bi ebeye kama. Yeah, that was say. What your time? Mba so baba support to come for. Yeah, that was say.
Misu, the only thing major only say a war Jesus you are at tempo. It after that there is a judgment. God bless you all. Bye bye.
And that's it.
Well, my name is Marcus. Yeah, Marcus Jellingford. Yeah, and I'm here as usual for the movie launch. So,
I'm glad, well,
yes.
They said that there was going to be a red carpet distant interview after all the shows. So now we are having it.
Okay. Auntie, we are actor, and I say, you win your first major movie.
No.
And a special welcome to the
I've played a lot of roles in other projects, but this one. It's totally Andrew, different. I started with this group way back in the middle of somewhere, middle of 2000.
We'll do some interviews.
And then this is just one of the ordinaries I featured in.
Stop. I don't know. Enjoy yourself, enjoy yourself, enjoy yourself. Who is coming? Who is coming? My sister, my sister, my sister.
Stay with our day.
Ik zie je baby, zo goed en maar ben. Zo goed en maar ben. Ik zie je baby, zo goed en maar ben.